Being raised by his parents, the Jedi fugitives Mali and Kento Marek, Galen Marek lived for a few years among the Wookiees on Kashyyyk. His mother was killed by Trandoshan slavers, whereas his father was soon afterwards murdered by Darth Vader during the Imperial sacking of Kashyyyk. However, before Vader could finish the job, Galen inadvertently snatched Vader's lightsaber with the Force. Sensing Galen's high concentration of Force sensitivity, Vader decided to take the young boy as his secret apprentice, in order to train him to take down the Emperor, dubbing him Starkiller. Over the years, Galen was ruthlessly trained as a Sith assassin by Vader and a training droid named Proxy. When he was 17, he was dispatched to kill several Jedi who had escaped Order 66, including the Jedi Masters Ram Koda and the Council member Shaak Ti. However, he was discovered afterwards by Darth Sidious, who ordered his execution. Afterwards, Vader retrieved the boy's body to have him revived and rebuilt. Starkiller was given a new assignment to assemble an army of rebels to distract the Emperor and his spies. After recruiting Ram Koda, who had miraculously survived their previous encounter, Starkiller eventually managed to assemble the Rebel Alliance with the aid of Koda's political contacts, including Senator Bail Organa. Once the Alliance was assembled, it was time to bring the fight to the Empire. However, Vader ambushed Galen and the rebels, revealing that the young man's entire life was a lie, and leaving him for dead. Galen finally decided that enough was enough. After scouring the Outer Rim and discovering the first Death Star, Galen finally confronted and defeated his master, and even defeated Darth Sidious himself. However, he was talked out of killing him by Koda, as giving in to his anger would drive him back to the dark side. As the rebels prepared to leave, Sidious attacked once again. Galen ultimately sacrificed himself to allow his allies to escape. His sacrifice ultimately inspired the rebels to finish his work, and the Empire was eventually defeated. Born 102 years before the Battle of Yavin, Dooku was taken into the Jedi Order at a young age, becoming the apprentice of Thame Cerulean, as well as being instructed by Jedi Grandmaster Yoda. However, Dooku's ideals set him at odds with the political status quo, eventually leaving the Order after the death of his former apprentice Qui-Gon Jinn at the hands of Darth Maul. After meeting the Dark Lord of the Sith, Darth Sidious, Dooku realized their political ideals were not so different. Sidious would take him under his wing as his new apprentice, dubbing him Darth Tyrannus. Dooku aided his master, subtly influencing events leading to the Clone Wars, and even recruiting the bounty hunter Jango Fett as the clone template. After the Clone Wars broke out, Dooku served as the leader of the CIS, while his master served as leader of the Republic. However, nearing the war's conclusion, Dooku was defeated in a lightsaber duel by the young Anakin Skywalker aboard General Grievous' flagship. After his defeat, Sidious encouraged Skywalker to execute the Count. Realizing all too late that he had been nothing more than a placeholder for Anakin, Dooku was murdered, which would soon after be followed by Anakin's own fall to the dark side. Galen Marek is a 17-year-old human male. His speed, agility, and strength are all very well honed thanks to the brutal nature of his training under Darth Vader, having been constantly broken down and built back up. While it's not stated in any source, it is clear to see that his base level of physical hardiness was elevated to superhuman levels after being revived on board the Empyrical. Since he survived having a solid stone table thrown at him, and Galen came away with just a few cracked ribs, and a few days later was able to fight and defeat Vader and Sidious. Naysayers may argue that Galen may have been able to use the Force to protect himself from the damage done by the table. However, I must disagree, as Galen almost always gets caught off guard by any Force-based attacks that he doesn't see coming. And he was clearly caught off guard when ambushed by Vader. At the end of the day, Galen Marek was a human tank. Count Dooku is a human male in his mid-80s, and despite his age, he is in fantastic shape for a man of his years. Since he spent roughly 7 decades of his life as a Jedi, it is likely that he would have used the sustaining power of the light side of the Force to expand his physical prime. Dooku is also one of the few Sith Lords to not suffer dark side degradation brought on by deep immersion in the dark side of the Force. However, due to his old age, he cannot keep fighting for incredibly lengthy periods of time, as his age and flagging physical condition seriously affects his stamina. Despite this, Dooku does not go to pieces under strain, and is by no means an old man made of glass. This one is obvious. While Dooku is in great shape, he is still incredibly old and suffers from limited stamina. Even if you consider Galen to not have a superhuman level of resilience, his training under Darth Vader would no doubt indicate that he can still take an insane level of punishment. Plus, due to the fact that he is much younger than his competition, he is going to possess greater levels of speed, agility, strength, and of course, stamina. Galen Marek gets the physical edge. As a lightsaber duelist, Galen Marek was known to be rather unorthodox thanks to his training under Vader. Vader forced Galen to balance out his skills rather than becoming over-specialized. Initially, Galen was only instructed in the basics of lightsaber combat, later studying all of the seven traditional forms and gaining a working knowledge of each, as well as studying and applying skills with a few of them. His preferred forms were Form 3, Sarisu, Form 5, Shien, Form 7, Juyo. Form 3 was created as an answer to the increased availability in blaster technology, but later became the embodiment of pacifist Jedi philosophy. Form 3's moveset is based around tight and energy-efficient defensive parries. Masters of the form are said to be invincible as a result of the perfection of their defensive technique, though somewhat lacking in terms of offensive viability. Galen's skill in Sarisu was refined enough to hold off Ram Kota's randomized Form 7 offense, and he was even able to briefly hold off Darth Vader's powerful and sophisticated Gemso offense. Form 5 was created as an answer to Form 3's lack of offense. It had two variations, Shien and Gemso. Galen studied the Shien variant, which was designed for blast deflection, but focused on aim deflection, deliberately aiming bolts back towards the shooter. Galen's skill in Form 5 is shown through his skills in aim deflection, as well as his almost constant use of the reversed hand grip tailored to the style. Form 7, on the other hand, is the most aggressive form of lightsaber combat, focusing on bold and direct, yet randomized and unpredictable swordplay. Form 7 is the most demanding form in both a physical and mental sense. However, the physical strain is next to nothing compared to the mental requirements, as it requires its practitioners to allow themselves to give in to the fury and become swept up in the thrill of battle. Form 7 also requires their practitioners to have mastered multiple forms so they have something to build their Juyo from, which tells us just how advanced Galen's skills are. Galen also has some skills in unarmed combat, even defeating an Imperial Shadow Guard by breaking his neck. Galen also had considerable skills of chaining in force-based attacks into his attack patterns, applying every avenue of attack available to him. Galen's typical approach in a lightsaber duel was to apply a mix of attack and defense, assessing his opponent, before then applying whatever skills and powers he decided were appropriate. All in all, Galen was an unorthodox, but highly skilled duelist. And while his primary combative effectiveness came from his use of the Force, his dueling skills are not to be underestimated. Count Dooku was one of the best swordsmen of his era. His skills were unmatched by all but Yoda, Mace Windu, and Darth Sidious. On one occasion, Dooku even managed to stalemate Darth Sidious during a sparring match, and held his own against Mace Windu on one occasion, and twice against Yoda. Like Galen, Dooku had a working knowledge of all seven forms. However, Dooku was a specialist in only one form. His chosen martial art was Form 2, Makashi. Form 2 is the only form developed purely for lightsaber dueling. It greatly emphasizes elegance and energy efficiency. In other words, fencing with lightsabers. Dooku embodied this very concept. His typical approach when combating opponents of equal or near equal skill was to apply a mix of attack and defense. His offense was incredibly precise, and he was an expert at working his way inside his opponent's guard, even demonstrating skills with the Sunda Gem Strike, destroying his opponent's lightsaber with a highly precise strike. When fighting defensively, Dooku was an expert at luring his opponents to locations of his choice for home field advantage. Dooku was even able to partially compensate for his chosen form's weaknesses. Since Makashi was designed for one-on-one lightsaber combat, it does not provide training in blast deflection or dealing with multiple duelists, but through intense training, Dooku was able to compensate, such as shunting aside his adversaries, allowing him to engage them one at a time, a technique also used by his first apprentice, Qui-Gon Jinn. However, due to its elegance, Makashi lacks kinetic force, and is weak against heavy-handed swordsmen, such as Gemso specialists. Though Dooku did develop fallback options, such as ankle sweeps, as depicted during his final duel with Anakin Skywalker in the Revenge of the Sith novelization. Dooku is also adept with Dunmotch. Dunmotch was the Sith school of psychological warfare tactics using verbal taunts to expose inner fear and doubt. However, this can backfire, the two most notable examples being in Dooku and Vader's final duels with Anakin and Luke Skywalker, respectively. Instead of exposing inner fear, they set forth a rage which allowed the Jedi to defeat their Sith adversaries. While some sources depict Dooku having skills in dual-blade fencing, he has never actually shown any skills in this method of fighting. Dooku is also skilled in unarmed combat, sometimes chaining such attacks into his lightsaber sequences. He has even demonstrated skills at chaining in force-based attacks, successfully exploiting defensive lapses on multiple occasions. On the whole, Dooku was a master of the lightsaber, and was only matched by the best. This one is relatively simple to call. Dooku is the more skilled swordsman. However, while I don't consider Galen to be on Dooku's level, I do consider him to be in Dooku's league. While Galen does have a highly effective defense, I do feel Dooku's skill is refined enough to be able to work around it. Naysayers may argue that while Galen defeated Darth Vader, a martial artist of skill comparable to Dooku, however this was more due to Galen's superior force abilities, as opposed to him being a better duelist. At the end of the day, I feel that if this was a contest of pure martial skill, Dooku would win. Count Dooku gets the edge as a martial artist and lightsaber duelist. Galen Marek was known to be a powerful force wielder. His power and skill is so formidable that Darth Sidious even admitted that he could have been his equal one day. His skill set was basic, however his use was far from that. His use of physical augmentation was considerable, though there was nothing particularly notable about it. He was capable of boosting his speed, strength and agility to superhuman levels, allowing for blast deflection and superhuman acrobatics. His telepathic skills were capable, though they were limited to the basic mind trick, influencing weak-willed subjects to do his bidding. His use of telekinesis was extremely powerful and varied. While he appeared to rip a Star Destroyer out of the sky, all he really did was redirect the already falling ship, and then he almost got crushed. Despite this, his more conventional combative uses were very effective. His force pushes were capable of sending multiple opponents flying, and even breaking through the force shields of opposing force wielders. He was also talented at guiding his thrown lightsaber to strike down targets from a distance. He was even capable of channeling telekinetic surges into the ground to off-balance and stagger opponents, and he's even used force choke to kill specific targets. His most offensively destructive power was the Force Repulse, a gathered burst of Force energy unleashed upon all targets in close proximity. However, his defense against telekinesis was extremely lacking. He was able to defend against any attacks that he saw coming, though his passive defenses for guarding against any attacks that he didn't see were practically non-existent. Galen was even capable of Force Lightning. He was capable of chaining it through multiple targets simultaneously, using it to charge up or short out machinery, and even able to channel it along his lightsaber blade, in a sense tripling his lightsaber range. On the topic of energy-based force powers, Galen also had some skills with Tutaminus, even able to temporarily contain the energy of Sidious's lightning. However, he wasn't able to protect himself from the resulting blast, which ultimately resulted in his death. At the end of the day, as a force wielder, Galen Marek is best described as a battlefield juggernaut. Dooku was also known to be a powerful adept of the Force, with a lot of natural talent. His use of physical augmentation was in fact quite clever, boosting his speed, agility and strength to compensate for his old age, but relying on technical sophistication and skill to best adversaries as opposed to overwhelming physical ability. Dooku's telepathic skills were highly advanced. In addition to the basic mind trick, he was capable of the Beast Trick ability, using it to tame a crate dragon, keeping it as a pet and commanding it to attack Quinlan Vos during their encounter. Dooku was even capable of forcibly ripping information from a target's mind. He has even used the Quetech meditation to conceal his force signature and move about undetected by Jedi, though he could be located by others who were actively looking for him. Dooku has some skills with the healing arts, on one occasion healing himself from a deadly plague, and on another occasion saving the life of General Grievous after a spaceship crash. His use of telekinesis was considerably powerful. capable of lifting multiple heavy objects at once, and on occasion without the use of hand gestures. He was even able to penetrate the force shields of opposing force wielders on multiple occasions, as well as applying skills with the force choke technique to great effect. And even using telekinesis for personal levitation, Dooku was a practiced hand in the use of force lightning, using it both in combat and for torture. His skill with this power was such that he could chain his lightning to multiple targets at once, and he has on multiple occasions exploited openings provided by his opponents to blast them with devastating barrages. Dooku was even a capable user of Tutaminis, able to block force lightning with his hands. On the whole, Dooku's skills with the force were matched by few. This one is a bit tricky. In terms of raw power, I'd say they're on par with one another, with Galen being slightly above. However, Galen's use of combative force powers is far more creative. While Dooku would no doubt be able to exploit Galen's lackluster defense against telekinesis once he's discovered it, I don't feel this would be enough. The use of force lightning and Tutaminis is also on par. I feel the clincher here is Galen's more creative use of the force, while I do believe that in most cases it's better to be really good at a few tricks than to know a lot of them. The problem here is, every combative use of the force that Dooku is good at, Galen is just as good at. And he is just as good at the tricks Dooku has no skills with. I give the edge to Galen Marek as a force wielder. While the game shows Starkiller wielding his own lightsaber throughout the whole story, this is in fact inaccurate. After his false execution, his Sith-style lightsaber was lost in the vacuum of space. After he was brought to consciousness, he was provided with the lightsaber from Ram Kota, originally provided as proof of Kota's death to Vader. Kota's weapon featured a bulky hand grip with hand wraps for improved grip. Originally, he used a single green Adagan crystal as the focusing lens. However, Starkiller later replaced it with the blue crystal of his father's weapon, which he retrieved from his family home on Kashyyyk. Dooku wielded a curved-hilted lightsaber. The curved hilt provided ergonomic benefits, which would bolster Dooku's fighting style. His weapon also featured a dual phase function, allowing him to shorten his blade to the length of a shoto for close quarters attacks. His lightsaber originally used a blue Adagan crystal as the focusing lens, but later replaced with a red synthetic crystal after his fall to the dark side, providing his weapon with greater cutting power at the expense of some maneuverability. This one is easy to call. A curved hilt of Dooku's lightsaber bolsters his fighting style, and the dual phase function provides him with more options in combat, whereas Galen's is the definition of standard. Dooku gets the edge in weaponry. And now we've reached the verdict. This match is incredibly close. This fight would almost certainly start out as a pure lightsaber duel. After a short exchange, Galen would quickly realize Dooku's preference for Makashi, and he would also notice his high level of skill. Galen would no back fall on his force abilities, maybe even chaining them into his lightsaber sequences. Dooku would no doubt respond in kind, however I don't feel this would be enough. Dooku's skill with the blade wouldn't be enough, as Galen would do everything in his power to keep this from being a pure lightsaber duel. While Dooku would no doubt exploit Galen's vulnerability to telekinesis once he's discovered it, I don't feel it would be enough, as Galen is a human tank who can take an insane amount of punishment. Not to mention we've seen him fight through the force choke of his master, so he would likely be able to fight through Dooku's as well. Eventually, after a long clash of blades and force abilities, Galen would outlast Dooku, applying all of his skills to keep him off balance, just long enough to provide an opening in order to defeat the Dark Lord. And thus, I declare Galen Marek, aka Starkiller, the victor. Well, YouTube, there you have it. My fifth versus video done and dusted. As always, I hope you enjoyed, even if you could disagree with the outcome. Feel free to comment and criticize below. As always, just remember to keep things civil. Any suggestions for future matchups are always welcome. And I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.